Hello, Reformers, and welcome back to Star Wars The Old Republic Bounty Hunter Edition. Now, when we left off, we had just arrived on Belsavis, and, well, see, that's the thing. We have two different story missions here. One is target-rich environment, where we have to, well, technically defeat, assassinate, capture, or whatever the case may be, those two fellows there. They do seem to be relatively difficult, but they are in this area, so that's the thing. The first thing that I've decided to do is go to Zael Barrow's starship because, well, that's the main mission. Not entirely sure about these right here, but maybe, just maybe, we'll be able to pick those off as we are traveling by along the way to another destination. I felt because this was the closest to our landing point, it might be an idea to start with this. So, let us head on into the phase. And, oh, this is actually prison transfer and processing. Okay, well, that's good to know at least. Now, where do I actually have to go? Ah, okay. It seems like all of the droids, at least in the vicinity, as well as some people, have also been defeated. So, there seems to be quite a war zone going on here. Now, bear in mind as well that we are using Blizz. It's about time that we actually use the little guy. Because, well, he's just so damn cute, isn't he? I mean, really. Come on now. He's really cute. So, that's really nice, in my opinion.
Sounds like Lover Boy's coming back. Ain't you gonna welcome him home? Hey, Zael! I like your plaything! Maybe I'll keep her a while! You ain't Zael?
Who's that, Jumaga?
Tell me where he's hiding, or I'm gonna crush Girly here like a bug!
I'm not with Zael, so how about you settle down before anyone has to get hurt?
Trying to play dumb? Cute. Ain't gonna work. If killing Zael's little girlfriend don't get you talking, then I can come up with something that will.
It's my job to track down Zael. End of story.
Bounty hunter, huh? Wait your turn. Ain't nobody killing him but me. Lucky day, Girly. You're still the only one left to rat him out.
You can just shoot me. I'm not telling you anything.
Cooperate and I'll get you out of this alive.
I'm not stupid. I'm dead. Zael, why did you have to play the hero? I wanted to leave when the first siren sounded. Zael insisted we stay to help evacuate if things got too bad. Too bad. Understatement of the year.
Looks like that didn't go to plan.
The central power plant failed, and the hangar doors are closed. Even our ship can't put out enough juice to open them. We're trapped. Zael stormed off after some argument with a warden. Said he had unfinished business. He took M30B to get the central power plant back online. Said not to wait for him. That's all I know.
Don't let me find out you've been forgetful.
I can go?
You ain't going nowhere, Girly. And your boy's gonna hear all about how you died before I kill him.
Back off, freak, or I'll get nasty.
You wanna be next?
Last chance. Let her go.
Lucky I ain't got time to peel you out of that can. Run, Girly. But when I find you, I'm gonna see how much you can scream before your lungs go.
Tupa to the booster. Woo, grandi tatio to the donkey!
I agree. I'm actually kind of weirded out by that guy because you think to yourself, really? Is he really going to be that blatantly violent? Really? I actually know his race. I know what he is a member of, but yeah, they're mostly known for being bodyguards and, well, in general, they're not Gamorreans, I know. I know they're not Gamorreans, but I can't remember the name of them for the life of me for some unknown reason. Usually I can, but, well, I guess it is just the commentary and all that sort of thing. But anyway, Yeah, those guys are known for being rather violent, and, well, being on Belsavis, I can assume that that is a criminal. Hopefully we won't encounter him again, because, I mean, he seems to have a huge grudge against Zael for some unknown reason. And, well, I mean, that's the thing. Pretty sure he would just create a grudge out of thin air, even if you were to just bump past him and barely give him a nudge. He would probably take offense to that. He seems to be quite the, shall we say, sort of violent, emotional individual, so he is probably going to... Yeah, he's not going to be happy, I suppose, but maybe we won't see him again. Maybe he's just one of those one-off characters, who knows. But anyway, we are now going to make our way over to one of the target-rich environment... Targets? Yes. How redundant. Target-rich environment targets. Huh, yes, exactly. So, yes, one of these guys. I actually don't know who it is. Who is it? Apex One. Okay. Apex One is going to receive us very soon. And how do I actually get past here? Oh my. Oh, this is not good. This is not good. This is one of those times, isn't it? Yes, it is. In the distance, we can see Apex One. He is currently firing at a bunch of Mandalorian converts, as you can see. He is actually a very large fellow. He is a special assault, by the looks of things. And, oh yes, he is going to be rather tricky to take on. We're going to use Fusion Missile first. I know I really don't like this ability that much, but I'm using it mainly for the fact that we kind of have something to use initially so that we can get, well, we can get something off and then it's just like, oh, damage over time. Yes, exactly. We want that kind of thing to go down here. Now, we do have the ability to reset our unload now, which is exactly really, really fantastically useful because, well, I mean, as you can see, it probably is our most damaging ability right now, I suppose. Yeah, I think it probably is, actually. So that is pretty nice, I got to say. Now, we are going to... see, that's the thing. Am I going to go down to the other target? That's the thing. I actually do not know. I think I probably will because you never know when and where the other targets are going to be because... wouldn't it be just absolutely hellish for us to travel through the entirety of Belsavis and then be like, okay, think I'll do that other mission now. And then it just so happens that all of them are in other places. Yeah, that would be pretty terrible. So yeah, we're going to head down to Redivus and see what kind of adversary he will turn out to be. To be or not to be. Alright, so among these rather colourful looking flora plant things, yes, words, use them, maybe I should. Okay, so yes, oh, he's a Weequay, and he's a gunrunner. Okay, so this reminds me actually of Tano Vic. Oh yes, Tano Vic from the Trooper storyline. Okay, so yeah, let's again start with a fusion missile, why not? I mean, I think it seems reasonably okay to start with that, why not? And then we'll just go for some, yeah, of course, then I moved, of course, yes, that always happens. Okay, so let's try and interrupt his tactical assortment thing and hopefully not get him as, whoa, okay, apparently Blizz deals huge damage. Of course he does. Well, technically all of the companions deal relatively similar damage, but that is very nice. Now, as you can see, look at that. Target-rich environment has now disappeared from this map zone, and it is now in the next one. So, apparently, doing that was the best way to go. So, yeah, we actually appear to be relatively close to where we need to go for the power plant access tunnels too. So, juxtaposition it is. Alright, so Belsavis has not been very nice. It hasn't been treating me very well, mainly because even though, I mean, look at the environment. The environment is, I would say, probably one of the best or better, shall we say, looking planets. Because it's probably in the top 5 or something, I don't know. I mean, it's got really tall trees, it has ice cliffs, it has flora and fauna that is actually quite rare to see. But The layout of everything is incredibly frustrating. But, of course, we do have our next target here. It is a Pistolier Commander. Now, do bear in mind that we are a little bit low level for Belsavis. So, yeah, she's level 42. We're going to actually see whether we can deal with her. I think it should be absolutely fine, but you never know. Oh, she's actually using Unload as well. Well, that's rather amusing, isn't it? And again, I move to interrupt Yes. Again, I moved to interrupt that. How fantastic. Well, at least I can reset it a little bit quicker, and then I can get a full charge. That's nice. So let's try and get a little bit of healing there, because obviously Blizz is not going to heal me. Yes, there we go. Ah, fantastic. Okay, so that was actually not that bad. I probably could have done even more damage if I had vented a little bit of heat there, but yeah, I don't think that's too bad. So I guess we'll just head on to the tunnels now. Okay, so upon eliminating a couple of Ratataki prisoners, they were in a very, very big group outside. Luckily, there was a very conveniently placed acid barrel standing right next to them. So yes, that was reasonably easy. But now let us head on into the phase and, well, see what we're actually going to be doing here. Oh. Well, there's a... Oh. Oh, hello there! Oh. Okay, apparently he's running. Blinded! Chase down Zael Barrows. Let's do that. Barrows, the word Barrows actually has a pretty nostalgic effect for me because I used to play Dark Age of Camelot. Do you know Dark Age of Camelot? I don't know whether anyone does anymore. It's kind of sad. But anyway, I used to play Dark Age of Camelot and spent basically all of my time because I was playing on such a bad computer that it literally would not even be able to give me 2 FPS. It literally gave me 1 FPS in any other zone than Barrows or Snowdonia. Hilariously enough, not entirely sure why, but Barrows was actually an instance or a flashpoint in this case. And yeah, it was pretty cool because I literally had 60 FPS in there for some unknown reason. No idea how I was able to do that because I had an integrated graphics card or something along those lines. And it was just amazing. It was utterly amazing because I was so used to having terrible, terrible performance and just walking around like I was in mud that having an experience like that after dredging through everything was just utterly fantastic. And if you can find a zone like that in a game like Dark Age of Camelot, then obviously you are pretty good. And that's the thing. Yes, also, I had to level there since... Wait a minute. I think the max level was level 50 at the time. I'm actually unsure whether they increased it after that in many of the expansions that followed after I left the game. But I was 37 or 36 or 34. I don't know. Somewhere in the 30s. And I spent so, so long just leveling up in Barrows. That was it. I just leveled up in Barrows.
Cut it a little close there, Em. Nice trap, you. I'd kinda hope the first time I met you, it'd be captaining your one-way trip to lockup.
Things rarely go the way we want them to.
That's deep. But you moonlight as a Jedi Master when you're not blowing up orphanages? Friend of yours? Hate to disappoint, but even your thick skull won't break through this force field.
What are you standing around for? Let's blast this place to pieces!
I don't throw temper tantrums.
It ain't a temper tantrum! Blast the generators and Zael ain't got nowhere left to hide! Soon as this field drops, me and Zael are gonna get reacquainted.
If he's dead when I get back, I'm gonna be real upset.
Don't you worry. I plan on keeping him alive a good long time.
Why? Why do I have to do the dirty work? You're the bully slash sociopath slash violent person. That's terrible. That is absolutely terrible. Okay, so apparently I'm gonna have to do this now. So, where do we have to actually even go? I guess we have to go down in the elevator. Well, I suppose this would be a good time as any to end this episode of here. So, next time, we are going to be disabling the north and south power generators and doing the dirty work for Skadge. It's just utterly atrocious that we actually have to work with this fellow now. But anyway, I find him rather annoying. Yes, I thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time.